India resides in villages. Unfortunately, majority of the rural population has limited access to primary healthcare services. The Government of India launched the National Rural Health Mission in 2005 to ensure that health services reach the rural masses, especially vulnerable women and children. Achieving the Millennium Development Goals of reducing infant and maternal mortality is the major focus. In order to make the community participation and decentralized planning more effective, efforts are being made to enhance the capacity of Panchayati Raj institutions to own, control and manage public health services and develop systems for community monitoring of health services. The need for establishing Village Health and Sanitation Committee was documented in NRHM guidelines issued in 2005. Deepak Foundation, a non-profit organization of Vadodara, Gujarat, took up the challenge of developing a system for empowering the community by establishing a sustainable and accountable community monitoring mechanism. The foundation developed operational guidelines on a pilot basis for formation and strengthening of village health and sanitation committees way back in 2006 as part of its larger public-private partnership project. The foundation utilized its vast field network in the process of formation of the Village Health and Sanitation Committee. Recognizing that the ASHAs, the grassroots level functionaries, play an important role in the last mile reach of public health services, it was keen to establish their linkage with the community. Later in the year 2009-2010, the government supported the member NGOs of GSA Gujarat in taking up the capacity building and mentoring of around 4,000 VHSEs in the state. As the first step, the foundation staff conducted Gram Sabhas in each village to generate awareness about the committees and their envisaged role in preparation of Village Health Action Plan and resolving village-level health issues. Consent of the community gatekeepers was sought for selection of members of the committee, such that this represents various economic and social groups, men and women. The secretary and president of each elected committee selected committee members. The members contributed to open bank accounts. The foundation developed guidelines for fund management, record management and relevant registers, and distributed IEC material related to community monitoring processes in all the villages of the districts to create awareness of roles and functions. The next and the most challenging step was to facilitate regular monthly meetings and supporting them in enlisting health issues and problems affecting their health outcomes, deciding on appropriate action plans, encouraging community to contribute the fund requirement, training for maintenance or transfer of records and registers, documenting minutes of the meetings with support from ASHAs, forwarding applications to various government departments to the block headquarter through the outreach staff of the foundation.
उन्होंने जब बताया कि ये आरोग्य में ये problem solve हो सकता है VSC के grant से, तो पुष्पा बहन करके उनसे मुलाकात हुई मेरी. जब मैं सभ्य बना तो मेरे को पता चला कि ये grant आती है, उसमें ये अपने पैसा वापस सकते हैं. तो यहाँ पर हमने 12 इंच का पानी का निकाल करने का यहाँ पर underground pipe दबाया हुआ है.
The listings of health needs of all VHSEs are documented, compiled and analyzed by the foundation. Shortage of drinking water, poor sanitation around the source of drinking water, inferior quality of all-weather approach roads in the village, closed health facility, inadequate visits by health functionaries, inadequate supply of IFA tablets were the major health problems recorded by the committees. Gradually, these empowered VHSEs started undertaking initiatives of utilizing funds needed for constructing drainage, soak beds and concrete platforms around hand pumps to maintain sanitation. The block level officials encouraged the VHSEs to utilize the funds to procure equipment such as weighing scales, stethoscope and other items required to facilitate A&M's visits to village and conducting nutrition health days or mamta days.
Agamni Arogya Samiti dwara vivid prakarni aje behanone sagarbha behanone mahiti aapi ane gamma swachhata vishe pan mahiti aapi ane kyarek gandki thati hoy to e gandki ne kevi rite dur karvu e pan aa arogya samiti ni ek javabdari na bhag rupe aave chhe.
Once in 6 months, written applications were sent to the concerned block level government officials on health needs that reassured unresolved issues. Jansambads or public dialogues were organized to address unresolved issues and grievances. It also aimed at improving the transparency and accountability of the block level administration. A number of issues could be solved on the spot by the attending officials, while a few were referred for district or state level intervention. Overall, the Jansambads became effective tools in strengthening the communities and community-based groups in tackling development challenges.
Amara gamma beno ne janni suraksha yojana vishe na kamo hu karya se ane vidva sahay na mate na hu samaj suraksha lagta vatta sant suraksha lagta kamo me karya se.
The Jansambads, though brought to light an important lacuna in the entire process, that VHSC members needed vertical linkages, support at PHC, block and district levels to sustain the grievance redressal mechanism. VHSCs were then federated at PHC, block and at district level. The entire process of creating an apex level body from village level to district level took around 4 years. The district level federation, comprising 24 members representing 12 blocks, met every month to liaison with district level officials and resolve issues which needed district level interventions. The village health plans formulated by the VHSEs were incorporated into PHC and block level health action plans through the federations, finally amalgamating in form of a decentralized district health plan. This was the first time in the history of the state that such a people-centric exercise was undertaken, and the district officials took cognizance of the felt needs while preparing health budgets. The foundation's effort in formation of demand-driven decentralized health action plan resulted into scaling up policy advocacy in the system and the program at the state level.